If you just want to see the Starfury shooting at each other, skip to the end. I needed a little break from playing Adobe Premiere, aka putting together my rather complicated KSP project overkill cinematics. After watching We Can Game If We Want To's Babylon 5 Starfury build, I was inspired to take a crack at it myself. Since it's literally been done, I wanted to do something a little different, so I opted to make the Thunderbolt variant of the Starfury. So for people who haven't watched Babylon 5 in a while or have never seen this epic of epicness, the original Starfuries are space-only fighters. They are considered one of the most realistic representations of small space fighters in sci-fi. Since it's vacuum-only, no need for to be sleek and aerodynamic. The Thunderbolt, on the other hand, is capable of both space and atmospheric flight. Hence, it needs to be aerodynamic and have controlled surfaces that work in an atmosphere. It's also got some weird-shaped wings holding the rather large engine nacelles. I've never done a replica and haven't built a plane in a really long time, so this may have been the wrong thing to do. Here's the first version I built. It's more of inspired by than really a replica. It doesn't really have the same silhouette. Since it's an aerospace fighter, I opted to go with the Rapier engines as they work both in atmosphere and in space. In the show, there are what looks like big vernier thrusters on the front of the nacelles and set into some kind of cowling. I figured I could replicate this look with an air intake, which would also do double duty as an air intake. I just placed the Werner engines onto an Oscar fuel tank and inset it into the air intake. In the TV show, the engines can rotate so the winglets are pointing inward during space flight and rotated outward for atmospheric flight. Obviously, that can't be done in stock, so I just left the winglets pointing out. I'm not sure what the angle is supposed to be, but I put them about 30 degrees so they can have a little bit of yaw authority. I would have expected this build to go right into flat spins with no proper vertical stabilizer, but it flew surprisingly well. With the low slung wings, I couldn't figure out exactly where to put the gears at first. I don't ever recall seeing a Thunderbolt on the ground in Babylon 5. Starfuries are typically docked in the back in the Cobra bays and dropped into space. I figured use the low slung nacelles to my advantage and put the gears directly in them, they're big enough. Surprisingly, it flies relatively well and can even get into orbit. So technically it's a single stage to orbit craft, though it does get up there pretty much on fumes. But I would envision it would dock with another mothership and refuel, but I haven't built one. I can make a re-entry and did land off camera with this. I lost the bottom two winglets. I'm terrible at getting back to a KSC. In this case, I did make it past Mount Whoops Too Short. I wasn't really satisfied with the look of this. It doesn't look quite as beefy as what we see on the TV show, so I built a somewhat bigger version. The problem is it's kind of front heavy and essentially a biplane with all the lift in the back. The center mass is too far ahead of the center of lift, so it really liked to pitch down. I just kept moving the engines back and playing around with the fuel locations to get them closer together. It doesn't fly nearly as well as the other version, and with essentially no vertical stabilizer, it drifts horizontally a lot. Look at this nav ball. Flown carefully, it does get into space eventually, but I did use a drop tank, so it's technically not a single stage to orbit. A better pilot could probably get into space without one, but it'll probably still be on fumes and not have the feel for re-entry. At least I didn't. The emphasis is placed on maneuverability by putting the maneuvering thrusters far from the center of mass on struts. These ships move more like something would in space, not like a World War II plane like X-Wings do. This predates Battlestar Galactica's reimagining and, of course, The Expanse, where you see a lot of these realistic Newtonian physics. The Thunderbolt is supposed to have a plasma pulse Gatling gun. I don't have any weapon mods in, so I just made do with modification of We Can Game If We Want To's rockets, which are basically a pair of separatrons attached to a small decoupler. I just clipped the separatrons in a little bit to make it look a bit sleeker and canted them to try for some spin stabilization. I added Oscar fuel tanks for each projectile. It shoots like crap though. Without giving away too much, at some point, the original Starfuries and these Thunderbolts do get in some battle. I thought I'd recreate a little bit of that by using We Can Game If We Want To's Starfury craft file. Why reinvent the wheel? Since it's a non-atmospheric ship, I just cheated it into space and rendezvoused it with my Thunderbolt. Yeah, those are being piloted by Excel and Werner from my cinematics. Unlike airplane dogfighting, where you can tell which way the target plane is going based on where it's pointing, I don't have that. So I'm adjusting my vector so I'm heading towards a target matching relative X and Y velocities, so I don't need to worry about leading my target. It also helps that it's not trying to change direction. Clearly the Starfury's weapons are better, and he's got 8 shots on the thing and firing itself was a 2. I just have 4, and the fourth one always goes wonky. Werner gets in some amazing shots, destroying the top of the Thunderbolt's rear fuselage and tearing off the top engines. But in the darkness, painstakingly maneuvering behind the Starfury, he gets his revenge. You rebel scum. Looks like the fuel tank went up, cockpit was destroyed. Now here are some gratuitous scenes of them shooting at each other. Since it's fully Newtonian, it feels a lot like Flight Assist Off in Elite Dangerous, which is why I run into things a lot. Now, aiming is basically just lined up by eye. I don't have any weapon mods, obviously, like BD Armory or even Raster Prop Monitor to try to get a better aim. I'm just using the default nav ball, pointing the ship right at the pink dot. Down with fascists. Ooh, looks like it took out the main fuel tank. After installing Kerbal trajectories, I was finally able to make a decent-ish landing at KSC. In order to save fuel, I only had the bottom two engines active. This also helps keep the nose up. Hey, I landed. Surprised I didn't lose the winglets. Now, in my final version, I used the Infernal Robotics washers to rotate the engines and winglets, just like in the TV show. They rotated inwards during space flight. They also let me rotate them into vertical stabilizers, which made atmospheric flight a lot better. Far less horizontal drift. In space, the winglets are rotated in. It makes no difference for flight, but I suppose it provides a smaller target. Speaking of weapons, to get a better look on the rocket launcher, I tried clipping the rocket motors inside the couplers. It didn't work. So I ended up putting up the original design from We Can Game If We Want to Starfury. It worked a lot better. Since these things don't really have warheads, they're essentially kinetic weapons, so they'd actually be more lethal if they were allowed to accelerate longer. In other words, if I fired further out, but then I'm more likely to miss. I have you now. I better get back to Project Overkill. Thanks for watching.